Hi, my name is Mike Harris. I'm from Crystal Pools. We've been building pools for 60 years now, and thank you for watching this how-to video. Today we're going to be talking about pool heating and try to make the selection quite easy for you. Really, there's three forms of heating these days, being solar, which everybody has heard of, there's gas, and there's electric heat pump. Firstly, the questions you'd need answered as to will help you decide what sort of heating to choose is if you have a spa, an example this pool does, then really you have no choice. It needs to be a gas heater. It's the only one that'll get it up to the temperature nice and quickly. And in a hot spa, you'll want it to be 30 degrees or so. So solar heating won't get it there. A heat pump may get it there, but it'll take quite some time. So in this pool, it's a gas heater for the spa. Now you can then choose to make the gas heater big enough that it can heat the pool as well. And that's only a very small price increase from the smallest gas heater you'd choose for your spa to a bigger one that'll do the pool and spa as well. So if this was the case, we would recommend you just stay with a gas heater that's big enough to do the spa and the pool. If you don't have a spa, then the questions are you going to use pool year round? Is it a long lap pool? If that's the case, then it really should be gas again, because gas is the only one that's going to work really efficiently in the middle of winter. Unless you go to a really large heat pump, which its initial purchase price is going to be very expensive, probably twice the price of a gas heater that would do it year round. So again, we'd recommend gas. If it's a family fun pool without a spa and you want to extend the season, then typically solar heating has been the heater of choice, because people think the heat from the sun is free, and that's true, but you'll need a little pump next to the pool filter that'll push the water up to the roof, through the collector and back to the pool. So you do have an energy cost in running that pump. Typically people will leave their solar heater on all the time in the belief that it's free, when in fact it's not, because it has that little pump running the solar heater. You also have the heat loss, where the water runs to and from the pool, up the pipes to the roof, from the roof back down the house and through the ground to the pool. So it's not as efficient as everybody thinks. There's still a place for solar heating. We still use it a lot. It works very efficiently. The third heating option is a heat pump. And if you're just looking to extend your season, so in other words, get you into the pool as the sun's starting to warm up in October or November, and keep you in the pool typically from April to May, then a heat pump is a really good option. You typically won't use it during the hotter parts of the summer. So there, whereas people with a solar heater will leave their solar running. So with a heat pump, you know it's going to be a little bit dear to run, so you'll turn it off. You'll only turn it on when you need it. So all of a sudden there's an energy saving there. And heat pumps are very efficient these days. Whilst ever the ambient air is 10 degrees or more, it will heat your pool. You can connect the heater to be part of your pool filter, or you can have its own little circulation pump as well. We typically install it with a circulation pump that keeps it very separate to the pool filter, and it has a thermostat on it. You can set the temperature, it'll just come on when the pool has dropped below the level you like, and it'll switch off when the heater gets to its right temperature. We put on a lot of heat pumps these days with great success rates. So hopefully that helps you. There's probably some other examples out there. If you've got a small pool with a spa, well, as I said before, a gas heater is your choice. This pool, if it didn't have a spa, it would either be a heat pump or solar. And that's a decision that you have to be comfortable with. They're both very good. They both work. They're both about the same price, similar running costs, all of those things. A lot of people don't like seeing the collectors on the roof or the pipes running up the side of the house. So if that's the case, then a heat pump is the answer. Hope I've helped. Thank you for watching this how-to video as part of Crystal Pools how-to series of videos. For more information, you could certainly go to our website and have a look there, or you could subscribe to our video channel to see further topics as they become available. Thanks for watching.